Hello, everyone. I'm Ivor. You've heard a lot today about the promise of AI to transform health and to improve access and outcomes. But there's a flip side. AI has the potential to exacerbate health disparities and further imbalances in equity. There's currently no established standard to ensure that data used to develop AI reflects the diversity of people and experiences around the world. And in healthcare, there's historically been a lack of representation of historically marginalized populations in areas like clinical trial research. This excludes groups of historically marginalized people from an important step in finding new ways to prevent, detect, or treat disease. Without diverse representative data, AI models could do more harm than good. At Google, our goal is to build for everyone, everywhere, and to improve access to and equity of care. This means we also need to build with everyone. An example of how we're building with an inclusive mindset is in dermatology. We've been exploring whether AI can help people better understand their dermatology issues or concerns. Along the way, we've realized that many existing dermatology datasets include primarily skin cancers and other severe conditions, yet lack common concerns like allergic reactions. Plus, images are often captured in a clinical setting and may not reflect a diversity of images, including different parts of the body, different skin tones, and more. I saw this firsthand when I went through medical school. In fact, it's estimated that less than 20% of dermatology textbook images contain dark skin tones, a statistic that has not changed in about 15 years. To correct the failures of the past, we need to ensure these biases are not repeated in the way that we build AI models. So we set out to develop a data set inclusive of skin tones from a diverse group of people, representing different levels of condition severity, skin tones, ages, genders, and more. Today, with Stanford Medicine, we're releasing the Skin Condition Image Network, or skin dataset, available to everyone. Thousands of people contributed photos to help build an open access dataset with over 10,000 images of skin, nail, and hair concerns. Dermatologists then labeled these de-identified images with a possible diagnosis. Then they rated them based on two skin tone scales to make sure the data set includes an expansive collection of conditions and skin types. It was amazing to see so many people contribute to the data set to help advance dermatology-related research. Ultimately, we hope this data set can be used to advance science and develop products around dermatology. Perhaps by helping scientists build innovative diagnostic tools, supporting dermatology-related research, or serving as a tool for educators to expose students to a wider pool of skin conditions and issues. I really wish I had that when I was in medical school. Beyond ensuring diversity of data, it's critical to understand whether AI models perform equitably. Meaning, do these models exacerbate existing disparities, or do they help give everyone a fair opportunity to be as healthy as possible? For almost any health condition, some groups of people have worse outcomes than others, oftentimes for reasons not even related to the disease itself. Here's an illustration of how we put this framework to use. Let's stick with dermatology. As an example, we are using HEAL, which we've determined is called Health Equity Assessment of Machine Learning, and we dubbed it HEAL for short. Using HEAL, we evaluated an AI model designed to predict dermatology conditions based on photos of skin concerns. So we asked ourselves, does this framework help ensure the model doesn't exacerbate health disparities? What about those who typically experience worse outcomes? And how about groups based on race, age, and sex? Here's what we found. The model performed equitably across race, ethnicity, and skin subgroups. But we discovered that it had some room for improvement when it came to age. Older adults, 70 and over, are at risk of worse health outcomes from skin conditions. Our model recognized that with cancers, but it did not when it came to more common concerns like allergic reactions. This is a great example of the HEAL framework doing what it was meant to do, highlighting where we need to improve our model. There's already been a lot of work to measure bias and fairness in AI, and we believe the HEAL framework adds another layer of evaluation. Our work at the intersection of AI and health equity is an ongoing journey. We're committed to building solutions that make healthcare more equitable, but this work takes time and intention. And the stakes are too high not to get it right.